Welcome to AlternativeTherapyClinic.net. Today let's talk about asthma, a very common problem in the modern society. Asthma is a chronic respiratory disease, and the most frequent symptom is difficulty in breathing. The basic cause of asthma is allergy, and allergies are the primary offenders for this disease. Around 70 to 90% of the people with asthma have allergies, and the most common allergens or allergy causing substances are pollen, grass, dust, tobacco smoke, and animal dander. When inhaled, these substances can trigger the release of histamine and other body chemicals, causing an allergic reaction and asthma episodes. Other allergens include chemicals, fumes like aspirin, ibuprofen, and other NSAIDs. NSAIDs stands for non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs, which are used for the pain killer and fevers. One of the reasons for the asthmatic factor is allergy related to heredity. Scientists have also discovered a gene that appears to make people susceptible to the disease. Now, once you are diagnosed with the asthma, what are the treatment options available with you? In the conventional allopathic medicine, we treat asthma patients with bronchodilators, drugs that help dilate the lungs constricted airways. These medications are available in two forms, inhaled and oral. Inhaled bronchodilators, which come in aerosol or metered dose inhaler form, resembles epinephrine. Doctors usually prefer inhaled bronchodilators such as albuterol. Apart from the allopathic treatment, we also have lot of alternative choices, which includes acupressure and acupuncture. Applying gentle pressure to certain body parts help in relieving some of the discomfort of the asthma. Reaching over your shoulder, left shoulder, with your right hand, press firmly on the part of your back in between the left shoulder blade and spine, which we call BL13 point. You can see it in YouTube or Google. Take 5 deep breaths, then repeat on the other side. Or put your fist on your chest, thumbs pointing upwards, and feel for the sensitive spot next to the breastbone. This point is called kidney 27, K27. Press this firmly for 2 minutes to get immediate relief from the asthma. There is also one point in acupressure which is CV17. It is in between the chest. You can also refer this point from the Google. But if you press this point for 2 minutes and press little hard, you will immediately get relief from asthma. Acupuncture, the same points, we can do acupuncture, and acupuncture in many medical studies have proved that acupuncture is really helpful. Apart from these therapies, we can use aromatherapy. There are few oils like eucalyptus, lavender, rosemary. These are the oils, if you inhale them, few drops, inhale through nose, this will help in releasing the symptoms. Few Chinese herbs are also useful. Like one of the Chinese herb which is widely used in the asthmatic patient is ephedra. Ephedra is a potent bronchodilator. Other thing which you can prepare an infusion by combining 5 grams ephedra, 4 grams cinnamon, 2 grams licorice and 5 grams apricot seed. Steep the mixture in water then bring it to boil and drink it hot. This is one of the Chinese formula which helps in immediate relief from the asthma. We also have some herbal remedies for this. One of the finest herbal expectorant is elecampane, elecampane. It helps in clear the body of excess mucus. The next alternative choice with us is homeopathy. Homeopathy offers a variety of treatment for asthma symptoms. Some general medicine you can take is arsenic alb 30c. Initially, when the symptoms are severe, you can take every 3 or 4 hours. Then you can make it twice a day. There is one medicine in homeopathy which is aconite. Take aconite 30. For aconite is basically an emergency medicine. For any acute problem, you can always go for the aconite. So if you have an asthma attack, go for aconite 30. Then we also suggest one mother tincture, that is justicia. Take around 20 to 25 drops of justicia in half cup of lukewarm water. Drink it 3 times a day. Do it for 1 week and your lungs will be cleared. It is for lung detox basically. The next alternative choice in the asthma is reflexology. Massage the skin between the big toe and the second toe on both the feet. This area is said to be correspond to your throat and lungs. Then flexing so that toes are spread apart, massage the ball of the foot, the area said to correspond to the lungs and the chest. Another option with the alternative choice if you or your child is suffering from asthma is the yoga. There are many yoga exercises which can help you in breathing deeply and to relax. But the most important is the pranayama. If you are having an asthmatic child or any asthma patient in your house, deep breathing is very important in asthma as it improves your immunity, as it strengthens your lungs and help you to counter the asthmatic condition. One of the major one of the biggest questions which most of the patient of asthma ask us is whether we should exercise or not. See, exercise is very important for people with asthma as it is for others. Equipped with proper medication, people with asthma can exercise normally. Many doctors in fact recommend swimming for people with asthma as humidity helps ease breathing. But the chlorine in swimming pools may cause allergic reactions, so you have to be careful while swimming. This was Dr. Kaushik from alternativetherapyclinic.net. Thank you.